Hey everybody, it's Alex, the founder and CEO at Motoroso.com, your dedicated mods marketplace. And today we're in studio to do a big installation project. We're gonna be installing the CR Performance exhaust manifold and the Stage 3 42 millimeter twin turbo upgrade kit. And this thing's gonna be making close to 500 wheel horsepower when we're done with a custom tune. Now this is a big install job. It's gonna take quite a while, a lot of steps to it. If you're doing these projects yourself, hopefully you find this video really, really helpful. So give it a thumbs up if you do, and subscribe to our channel for all of our other videos coming up soon. If you're shopping for the full bore manifold or the turbo kit or any other CR Performance products or all of your mod needs, check us out at Motoroso.com or call us toll free at 1-833-MOTOROSO. That's 833-668-6767. Let's get started. Now there are a lot of steps to this installation process, and we're not gonna outline all of them here at the beginning, but there's a couple of schools of thought when it comes to how to get the downpipe out of the way. Now you can definitely remove the whole exhaust system, take the transmission crossmember down and get the downpipe down and out of the way, but that is a lot of work. We just did that on our Raptor downpipe install. It's a ton of work with that transmission crossmember. We believe we can do this by jacking the front up, taking the wheels off, getting the inner fender liners out, and then having access to the turbo from the side, and we can just sort of maneuver around the downpipe. That's the way we're gonna try and do it. We think that's easier, but there are a lot of other steps. Follow along, let's go. Tools you'll need for this job include a Torx 47 and 50, sockets ranging from 5.5, 10, 13, and 15 millimeters, ratchets to make all that work, a pick, a panel puller, and a torque wrench. Start by jacking up the truck and removing the front wheels. Remove the pop clips and retaining screws on the fender liner. And if you have fender flares like us, you'll need to remove those as well, then remove the fender liner. On the driver's side, there's a slight difference in the fender liner due to all the electrical connectors that are clipped into it. They can be easily popped out from the engine bay side. Ziptie or bungee the wires up and out of the way. Drain the coolant from the petcock on the driver's side of the radiator. While the coolant is draining, disconnect the battery. On the passenger side of the engine, you have to remove the starter in order to have enough room to access the lower side of the turbo. Remove the two 13mm bolts on the back side of the bell housing. Begin removing the intake and intercooler silicone hoses with a 7mm socket. You may have to remove more of the intake to get the inlet boot off the turbo. For maximum clearance on both sides, we suggest removing the full intake. The mounting bolts on the turbo can be stiff to remove due to the intense heat cycling, so spray them down with penetrating oil and let them sit while we remove all the lines off the turbo. Remove the two 15mm nuts for the downpipe. Simply pull off the wastegate vacuum hose. On the underside of the turbo, there is one coolant line held in by a C-clip, and the oil drain is held in by two Torx 50s.
Now on the top side of the turbo, remove the C-clip holding the other coolant line into the turbo. With all the lines removed, the turbo is ready to come out. Remove the three Torx 47 bolts mounting the turbo to the exhaust manifold and pull the turbo out. Some extensions and swivels will be needed to get the angles you need to remove the 8 15mm nuts from the exhaust manifold. Now you'll repeat almost all of these steps on the driver's side, starting with the intake and intercooler boots, moving to the downpipe 15mm nuts, then the two coolant lines. On the driver's side, do not remove the coolant line from the back of the turbo, but instead from the engine block by removing the Torx 47 retaining bolt on the tab and simply pulling it out of the block. Then remove the C-clip from the top coolant line, finishing with the Torx 50s on the oil drain and the Torx 47s on the exhaust manifold mount. Remove the turbo from the engine bay and get to work on the 8 15mm nuts for the exhaust manifold. With a pair of channel locks, remove any broken studs left in the engine block and any non-broken studs, you'll use a 5.5mm wrench or socket. Clean the engine block with some brake clean and a rag. Install all new studs into the engine block with a 5.5mm socket. Place the new gasket onto the exhaust manifold studs. Install the new CR Performance exhaust manifold with the supplied nuts. Follow the supplied directions from CR Performance for your specific vehicle for the order and final torque specifications of the manifold nuts. Prep the turbo to be installed by installing the mounting gasket and the downpipe backing plate. We recommend buying new backing plates from Ford, as well as new downpipe studs. On the passenger side, install the coolant line to the back of the turbo, being held in by a C-clip. Install the new CR Performance turbo to the exhaust manifold. We recommend getting new Torx 47's mounting bolts rather than reusing the old stock ones. with the turbos loosely mounted, install the oil drain with a new gasket and torque to 10 pound-feet. Connect the two coolant lines by simply pressing them into place and line up the downpipe before fully tightening down the turbo to its final torque of 38 pound-feet. Now to the passenger side to repeat the process. Clean the block of any excess carbon buildup and install the new studs first, followed by the new header gasket and then your CR Performance exhaust manifold. With the manifold installed, loosely install the new CR Performance turbo, connecting to the coolant lines and oil lines first, then followed by the downpipe, and finally tightening up the mounting Torx 47s to 38 pound-feet. With the turbo fully plumbed and torqued in place, install the intercooler and intake couplers, reusing the OEM hardware. Don't forget to reinstall the starter, reusing the OEM 13mm nuts. Before reinstalling the fender liners, fill the engine with coolant and connect the battery, then start the truck to make sure everything is operating properly and you have no leaks of exhaust, oil, or coolant. If there's no leaks, Reinstall the fender liners, making sure to connect the electrical connectors on the driver's side, inside the fender liner in the engine bay, and put it all back down on the ground, ready to be retuned and make some real power.
All right, that wraps up our installation process. Very big project. Hope you found the video helpful. Give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for everything else that we're doing. Now, when you want to shop for CR Performance Turbo Upgrade Kit, the exhaust manifold, or any of your product needs, check out Motoroso.com or call us toll-free at 833-MOTOROSO. That's 833-668-6767. We've got over a million top name brand products sold by trusted vendors at great prices, and our shipping is always free with no minimum. Thanks for watching.